The humiliating treatment from the two young men looking down on me in the gutter in 45th Street reminded me of those sort of instances when you either overhear things from the stage or you overhear things from an audience coming out of a theatre. I always remember when we were running side by side at Wyndham's Theatre here, I was able to go to a Wednesday matinee of Dr. Jonathan Miller's production of Chekhov's Three Sisters, and I came out behind two American matrons, one of whom turned to the other as she exited and said, more a play than a show, wasn't it? And I got a, while I was in New York, I got a letter from Carol Brahms, who'd been to the Chichester Festival to see Sir John Clements and Margaret Leighton doing Antony and Cleopatra, and she was going across the car park afterwards and heard one West Sussex matron turn to the other and say, "Something very similar happened to Monica." The classic one which my friend, the late Martin Tickner, told me he heard when the Oliviers and Peter Brook put on Titus Andronicus, that most bloodthirsty of Shakespeare plays at Stratford. You know, limbs are cut off, tongues are pulled out, two young men are chopped up, baked in a pie and fed to their mother. And this county pair were going across the car park to their Land Rover at the end of the performance, and the man turned to the wife and said, "All we need to find out now is that the dog's been sick in the back of the car." As I said, sometimes you can hear it from the stage. The classic one, it may be apocryphal, is an old actor right in the middle of Macbeth, and he says, "Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow." The little old lady in the front row turns to her companion and says, "Oh, that'll be Thursday." Judy Dench swears that when she was in The Promise, a modern Russian play at the Playhouse at Oxford, with Ian McKellen and Ian McShane, it was a very gloomy Russian play, but a modern one, three acts, and in the third act they came in swathed in furs, fur hats, fur coats, fur scarves, fur tippets, fur boots covered in snow, and they advanced towards the front of the stage to begin act three, and they were barely able to finish it because an old lady in the front row turned to her companion and said, "Oh, anybody think they was in Russia?" I always remember, again, at the Wyndham's one matinee afternoon, David Kernan was singing most beautifully one of Sondheim's quieter numbers, "Anyone Can Whistle," I think, probably, caressing the melody, and again, the legendary two old ladies, and I saw one nudge the other, point, and say in a quite audible voice, "Oh, look, Turnips is coming back." Well, Turnips are back with a vengeance tonight. Mr. Kernan still has his Turnips. He also has the benefit of a great cellist, Paul Watkins, accompanying him. And Turnips and Paul Watkins and David Kernan and two songs from Merrily We Roll Along.